Good morning and welcome to the Hometown Morning Show with Tori and Kyle. Welcome to Lilly Novak from Henry Mayo. She is the Community Outreach Coordinator for Henry Mayo's Community Education Office, here to talk about National Nutrition Month. I guess March is National Nutrition Month, huh?
Yes.
So, Lilly, quick question. We will not be talking about cookies at all today. Is that what?
No.
No cookies.
Not the hot topic today.
Okay. Well, Lilly, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
What are we going to talk about?
We are talking about National Nutrition Month, and during the month of March, everyone is invited to join us for a lot of informed food choice classes and different nutrition and dietetic offerings we're having at Henry Mayo.
For example,
we have Nutrition for Liver Health. There's going to be a new pop-up class happening on March 16th.
Oh, wait, let me stop you. Liver health. Let's talk about liver.
Yep.
Why is that so important? Why do we need to treat our liver good?
Our liver.
Or well.
Gets rid of our toxins. So we want to make sure we treat it well and that it's getting the nutrients to thrive.
And do that?
No, it's a huge problem, people having issues with their liver, so we want to make sure we bring it back to health.
How do we know if we're having liver issues?
Maybe if you're finding you have some inflammation or your lab work is showing high levels of creatinine and things like that.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. So it's blood work and maybe some inflammation. We're like, what's this going on here? And we need to eat the right things to make our liver healthy.
Yes.
Who knew we needed a healthy liver? I mean, I know we need like healthy stuff, but like health, like liver, you're having a class on the liver.
Liver is actually the only organ that can regenerate itself.
That I knew. I think I got that right in Trivial Pursuit. That one I knew. So we have liver. We're going to take care of our liver. What else are we going to take care of?
We are going to have on March 28th a Personalize Your Plate. We really focus on eating a balanced diet, and we want you to eat foods that you enjoy. So personalize your plate, but still make it healthy. And that's going to be on March 28th at 10 a.m.
They say, and so I've heard, that we should have a lot of colors on the plate.
Yes.
Like that's the more colorful, the better.
Is it true? Yes, that's absolutely correct. We want more color because all the colors offer different vitamins and nutrients that your body can use. And
so here's the thing. I can get like a great slice of pizza with pepperoni and peppers and mushrooms, and there are a lot of colors on there. Not necessarily the best food choice.
Well, you know, if you are choosing pizza and you chose to put onions, pepperoni, and peppers on it, I'd give you a thumbs up.
Really?
Yeah. We got to choose things we like and add the vegetables where we can, right? So
I love it. Okay. All right. It's called Fill Your Plate, Balance Your Plate.
It's called Personalize My Plate.
Personalize My Plate. Okay. And what else we have?
All right. We also have a really big pop-up class we're reaching out to the schools to share. It's called What's Wrong with Hot Cheetos? And one of our dietitians, we know Hot Cheetos is a big hot snack that kids love and adults love too, but one of our dietitians put together this class just to take a closer look at the ingredients in Hot Cheetos and maybe make it not your number one choice every time you have a snack.
Well, Cheetos in general, I mean, the fact that like your fingers turn orange after just a few.
Yeah.
And I love a good cheese doodle. But I can't eat the hot one. The hot ones are way too, like, I had one and I was on. Andrew, our producer here, you're digging that. You like the hot ones? Yeah. Do you know what's in them, I guess?
Yeah, I was taking a closer look with my dietitian that works with me in the office, and we were looking at the ingredient list. What was surprising is that in the hot Cheetos, the spicy ones, there was no actual spice. It was citric acid that really emphasizes that spiciness. So it was very interesting.
And is that not good?
It's
not the best.
It's not the best, but, you know, everything in moderation. That's what we're working on.
But here's the problem, Lilly. Let me just be frank with you, okay? Some of the flavors, like those hot Cheetos, the hot is almost addicting. Like, you have them and you want more. It's almost like you crave more of them.
Exactly.
And so when you say moderation, that just can't happen. Like, how do you, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, there are definitely some addictive properties and ingredients that we'll point out in that, on that ingredient list.
Okay.
So yes, that's definitely, an addictive type of food for sure.
Okay. All right. What else we got?
All right. We also have, understanding food choices for celiac disease. We know gluten-free, going gluten-free maybe was a big fad diet, but celiac, people who have celiac have to go gluten-free for health reasons. So we have a class offering all about gluten-free food choices.
Is gluten, as long as we're talking about this, because I know it's a big, I knew a lot of people in the 90s started taking out their gluten, not because they had celiac, but it was the thing to do, like you said, kind of a fad thing. Is gluten generally bad for us?
No, I would say it isn't. You know, gluten is found in foods like wheat, barley, rye, and those foods do contain great nutrients and fiber that our body wants and needs. For people who have celiac, the reason that they can't have gluten is just the protein inside the gluten irritates their intestines. So,
and that can cause a whole bunch of weird stuff happening. I mean, I've heard I have friends who have celiac who have hair loss. Lost a tooth, just fell out.
And the reason being, when you have celiac, you're not absorbing those nutrients because your intestine's being damaged. So that's why removing the gluten will heal your intestine back up on its own, and you can absorb those nutrients, won't be losing your hair or losing your teeth any longer, hopefully.
Fantastic. And when is that, the gluten?
The Understanding Food Choices for Celiac Disease is going to be on March 18th at 3:30. And all of these classes you can join in person or on Zoom if you prefer. And the way you register is on our website, henrymayo.com/classes.
Lilly Novak, she is the community outreach coordinator for Henry Mayo's Community Education Office. Lilly, thank you so much. I gotta tune into. You know, it's the Cheetos one.
Exactly.
I gotta find out about the Cheetos.
Yes, we'll definitely send an invite.
Lilly, thank you so much for joining us today. Appreciate it.
Thank you.